And so, as I continued praying, the Holy Ghost began to echo the scripture. He that considereth me shall not see. And after a while, the Holy Ghost said, the pandemic is the wind. And there are many who are using it as an excuse not to be committed to Jesus. Those who used to give, they say, I have no money again. The wind, they are considering the wind. Those who used to go for evangelism, say, now wisdom now. But they come for your head, they tire you, carry for your shoulder. So that when the heavy is small, you drop out. But God said, if you want to harvest, ignore the wind. And so, in one of my personal vision, I came downstairs. I booked the kick ticket before I continued my prayers. In the morning, he told me why I booked the ticket. He said, when to when? He said, if you have told me, I wouldn't have allowed you that way. He said, I'm sorry. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
No, so I'm here today, not because I want to be here, but because the Lord compelled me to be here. I don't know the reason. I don't know who is that person. The Lord wants me to be here to meet. I have played my part. I have obeyed God. Now you have a role to play. Either you are going to sit down there and just watch like who read Luke chapter 1. I used to tell people, if you are coming to my meeting, don't read Luke chapter 1. Because it's making you to be looking too much. All you want to say, God, this meeting is for me. Therefore, I'm going to take it very serious. Settle me. Turn my case around. Cause efforts to remember me one more time. Cause the doors of the nations to be open. Some of you, you are in the wrong place in life. Are you hearing me? Some of you, after this meeting, like an arrow in the hand of a warrior, we will shoot you to the nations of the earth. Amen. Only three people, because the other people didn't believe. So, if you are the one, then you are the one. Amen. There is no force in the kingdom. So, we started in the morning by reading at Isaiah 10:27. I want to thank God for God's servant for the privilege to be here. God bless you, man of God. It's a privilege. It's not an entitlement. Are you hearing me? He can choose not to listen to God, and I will be in another state for now. So, come with me. For those who are not with us in the morning, the Lord bless you. We have it on we recorded it for because of your Wi-Fi is very low, yes. And we have to get to the UK before I upload it to the YouTube. But you listen to me. So Isaiah 10:27, we started from there. So it's about a man who came to a position in life that he began to take life serious. He began to conclude that whatsoever is going through should come to an end. That whatsoever is happening in his life is not the will of God. You will remain where you are. far until you are dissatisfied with the happenings around you. No man rise by mistake. No man rise by wish. Men who are men who became, who have wishful thinking, they don't go anywhere. Ah, I wish somebody would just stop me. I wish somebody would just give me a car. I wish somebody would just. Nobody rises in the kingdom by wishful thinking. So, we'll talk more about that tomorrow. But today, let me just paraphrase, take a step backward. So, in the beginning of Isaiah 10:27, he said, it shall come. And it shall come. So, there is a word that those who study English call it conjunction. He said, when you seal the word conjunction, it means the statement did not start there. Conjunction is a word used to join two sentences or phrase together so that it can make sense. So, there has been a communication before that 27. When you hear the word hand, it tells you that something has been ongoing. And the writer is trying to join together what has been happening before to what is happening now. So the prophet said, and it shall come to pass. It's a definite statement of a man who needed a change. And so I made it clear in the morning that until you come to a place in life where you have to decide that this life I am living is the wrong life, something has to change. What you are not uncomfortable with, heaven has no commitment to change. Some of you, you are here you are today because you are giving a good reason why you should be there. Look at the family you're from. No solid pillar in that family. The only explanation you can give is we'll not get anybody to help us. Nobody will help you until you come to a position to say no. This thing cannot continue. Don't just sit in the church or walk through life without an hunger to achieve something. It does not matter where you are today. It does not matter the position. What you are experiencing, this same Jesus can turn your life around. Amen. And I'm here with a mandate that if you listen to me and you do what I ask you to do, when next we will meet in Canada. Amen. That sister did not believe me. She just did like this. Say Canada. I never could come up with this in Canada. This man of God said. God has the capacity to change your status. But you must be willing to refuse what the enemy is presenting you. And after you do that, you stay there in the morning. That you must be dissatisfied. You must agree to say, this is not my life. This is not my life. God, change my life. That was what Jonathan said. How old are you? I hear people say, oh, I'm still young. Oh. If you don't start it now that you are young, Okay. I was 17, 18 when I began to develop hatred for poverty. 17, 18 when I left my mother, I was raised by her. I knew if I stayed with her, there is no escape. Yes, I was born again, tongue speaking, but I needed to take a decision that will announce my life, that will change the course of my life. If not, I will continue with the path the enemy has placed me. Are you okay with where you are? Do you really think you are in the right position in life? I met a lady in the United States. She was sharing testimony. Doing well. She was talking. While she was talking, the Lord opened my eyes. I saw that she was living below average. Of what Jesus is doing. Your location does not determine your position in life. I have heard men to say, he tied your only if I cross. I smiled. I have seen men who cross and their life cross completely. I told you of a medical doctor who crossed to the United Kingdom. While he went to with his wife for lunch, they crossed his life and gave him epilepsy on the spot, free of charge. I said, yes, I agree with you. Things are messed up in this country. I've been around for a few weeks now. I agree with you. But I'm telling you, if God does not help you, even if you are in the United States, this will not make sense to you. So, this meeting is a meeting of people who are ready to change. Who is a man of God? Introduce me to the God who helped you. Now, we started in the morning. We went further. We said, we dealt with the issue of battles. There are a lot of us are carrying battles that we ought not to carry. And if you don't choose your battle wisely, you will end up fighting unnecessary battle that will slow down your pace in life. Have you ever seen a man who fights on different fronts and still make it? You need to face where you are going. So, we dealt on the battle surrounding destinies. Limiting destinies to make it. Oh God. We dealt. Okay, let's move forward. Who is ready for me again, sir? Ready for me again. I want us to go a bit deeper. Let me talk about something different. We talked about battles. Let me talk about something different. Yes, sir.
And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing.
We'll talk about the anointing tomorrow. Let's dwell on the yoke. Okay, sit down. Thank you. Let's dwell on the yoke. What is yoke? Yoke is a restrictive object used to restrict a person or an animal from getting to its desired destination. will see low for those of us who grew and were our beautiful parents who were farmers. Or you go to the north, you see yoke. It's an object you put in the net to control and to determine the action of an animal. And so it is in the realm of the spirit. After you have dealt with the battles that surround you, after you have dealt with the battles that surround your lineage, the next thing you need to deal with is the yoke. The main primary aim of a yoke is to introduce limitation. What is limitation? Limitation is progress that has limits. Limitation is progress. What did I say? Progress that has what? The person is making progress, but there is limits to the progress. Things are happening. Like that sister I saw in the US. She's naming the things she has achieved. But in the realm of the spirit, when the Lord opened her hands, there is limit to the progress. You get married. Let me allow you to get married. After one child, no more child. That is progress. But there is limit to what? Talk to me now. Can they hear me?
Yes, sir.
Are people wet up pigeon?
No,
people are young people now. Even daddy is a young man. Amen.
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 Amen. Too many people are carried away with the progress they experience. They look at their life. I'm making it. Yes, indeed, you are making it. But there is limit to your making it. One of the strong demonic attack on a destiny is to introduce that destiny to a progress that has limit. So that you be comfortable. It is called Satan deception. You just got one money, 3-5 million. Millionaire. Yes, you are a millionaire. But that money is a progress that has limits. You know why? Because it gives you a sense of arrival. Whenever you see a man who has a sense of arrival, know that that man is under an attack. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Whenever you experience a major breakthrough and you begin to experience a sense of arrival, go for prayer. Something is wrong.
Yes, sir.
Because the major breakthrough is not yet come. The enemy wants to make you to be comfortable in that situation. Some of you, you've cashed money, you've handled money. But have you noticed that from the last major money that entered your hand, nothing again? You know why? You thought you were alive, you became comfortable. Unknown to you, your case has been solved. Life only responds to men who are dissatisfied with where they are and who are ready to move forward. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
What have you achieved that is giving you a sense of arrival? Your case is number one. They don't summon you.
Yes, sir.
We are praying with a young man who was under a demonic siege. You know, we pastors, when we talk at times, members will think that Abel will talk too much. They want now see the one raised now. Now see. But you know, poverty mentality, how much do you really have? The one that you are thinking you are high, but how much? I told this young man, your life is under attack. Oh God, tight. The same man of God. I know what I want. If I can get this money, I know what to do. I told you, even if you get this money, you will know what to put on the money. He refused to listen. I tried to encourage him for deliverance. He said, I just need breakthrough. You don't have the right to pray for breakthrough if you have not turned the battles over your life and the yoke the enemy has placed on your life. Because if you experience breakthrough before that, you will regret. To help him, he left. Okay. Number one principle, now I'll preach it. I don't pursue people. When life deal with you, you don't know where I've been. And when you come back, you will suffer. You go fast, and I'm going to eat. Me be fast for you, I know where. When I be fast for her, who fast for me? When I wake up in the night to pray, you be snoring, you'll be snoring. This brother, God bless, 6.20 million entered his hand. He took part of the money, you know. He went to buy Jeep. The average Nigerian mentality. Poor mentality. He forgot where God has been covering him. He took his seat. He went to another ministry and paid tax. So, no problem. I will go there. You not go down, I'll not go down. We will see you laugh. He started making laughs. BA. For only 6 million. You see, God will punish poverty. Amen. That money finished less than 6 months. Not even his wife gets 50,000 from it. Jeep to buy another Toyota Camry. The last time I heard, engine, no. Because he started doing dancing. The yoke over his neck refused him to move forward. From now there I heard, I need only 60,000. I said, may God deliver you. When you were having 6 million, did you remember where God lifted you from? Now you want me to bless your 60,000. He's suffering today. Yoke! When we are talking about yoke, it introduces limitation. Remember what's the meaning of limitation? Progress with what?
Limit.
Again.
Progress with limit.
Say it loud. We bought a brand new car. Jesus bless us. That's the prayer. Jesus bless us with a brand new car. And brethren began to say, let's come and celebrate. Let's go. And I looked at them. Why? Because we bought a brand new car. So we paint the whole area black. Let me tell you what. what we do as a family is blessings. Every time we experience a measured opening, is the time we pray more. Every time. We are not carried by the material things. No, no, no. We know that every opening is a symptom that there is a greater harvest ahead. If we are comfortable with it now, that may harvest, we will not carry it. So God is blessing us with your prayer. Vigil, prayer. Life is full of battle. Stop working as if that nothing is happening. So, some of you here, you have good plans, so things you want to do, but you notice every step you make, there is a limitation. You see something is pulling you back. Something is pulling you back. That is a yoke. It prevents you to get to your desired destination. Now, let me ask this question. Those of you who are seeing vision, if I lay hands on you, you will see a Jamaican. Under this hot environment, you are still seeing vision. I'm watching your face. Amen. So I want you to today. Let me ask you a question quickly. How many of you believe that your destiny is to make it in this life, not in heaven, because you will go heaven? So let me talk about it. If you don't believe, don't do your hand like this. Eh? If you believe, not everybody will make it now. Not the first. Stop first star system. Everybody. Who go open gate? You believe that? Wave it. You believe? Wave it again. Now, get up. You see, I like your mama get up. You get up with power. She's born again. Sit down again. Now, look at that young boy. Look at that man. Go carry a block. It go easy for you, eh? It go easy for you. Stand up. How many of you truly believe in your heart that in this life you will make it? How many of you believe? Now, put your hand up. Remember standing. I said one of the reasons of yoke is that it's introduced into life to prevent people from getting to their desired destination. There are some of you, if not the yoke in your life, where God would have placed you by now. Even you yourself will be surprised. Some of you are a very hard worker. You are not as lazy as the, according to Buhari, lazy Nigerian. Oh my God, except lazy. If you're not lazy, this for work when, are you? You are hard working, but there is no meaningful progress. When yoke is at work, even when you locate your helpers or destiny, they cannot help you the way they want to help you. Have you not heard when somebody said, I would have done this, but have you not heard it? It don't promise you. He said, I love you. I would have done this, but a yoke is at work. Because if that will help you. The enemy knows that you will move faster. When a yoke is at work, yet people succeed, you will get there, you will be struggling. When a yoke is at work, you have information to a major door. You will open it, you will not enter. Somebody else will enter. We are going to pray. Every yoke that is at work in my life, listen, as you begin to pray now, we will know those who are serious. Those people, they don't need any motivation. The ones who are not serious, they want people to say, pray, pray, pray. Let me borrow that worry word again. I like it so much. He said, every abonki. Sister, you are born again. Every mala with you. If you like, no pray. If you like, be looking like who drank Lucozet. I got to Sample. I speak into Sample to keep my mom treat. I saw people I used to see blow. They were not taking life serious 15, 25 years ago. The difference is clear now. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Ask our fathers. They will tell you. It is what you sow to life that you will reap.
Yes, sir.
So in the next few minutes, when we begin to pray, if you like, be looking like that sister that you are hiding. Good news for you. Bad news for you. No matter how you look, somebody else will beat you to it. Actually, if you, some brothers, you know, they look good, they be smart. When I was to marry my wife, I never knew another spiritual brother was behind her. In fact, he told her, he cannot take care of you. What does he have? Now, red sun, now they have to do the house. I got married to the office sister who was looking for a ready maid. My wife married me, I was living in the red sun. In fact, this is the house ceiling now. My own house cannot get ceiling. If you visit me and you want to put vest, we they call that singlet in those days. Don't change and put vest. But you know what I talk.
Yes,
the heat will go beat you. But she saw a future that nobody saw. The pastor said, don't marry him. This is a poverty dog killer. Now, mother, so. I told my wife, yes, so my mother, I must have been packaged, you know, so I do. My mother, so, but if you follow me, listen, if God can take me from mothers, how low is your, how many of you stay mothers? They're not the same. Oh, you are the mothers. God, may God deliver you.
Amen.
May the God who deliver me deliver you.
Amen.
Take your picture for the next few years. I don't take my own picture, it paid me. At the time I take a picture, say it does destroy you. Take a picture. May you hear me? Eh? So we are going to pray. I want you to take your life serious. I want you to address the yoke in your life. And as we pray, the God of heaven will intervene.
Amen.
If we have time, in the hands of the Holy Spirit, the anointing will be sent. But if not, tomorrow morning, I will be dealing properly on the oil of acceptance. So, you don't want to miss it. I will just remember now that I have another session tomorrow evening. Now get ready. Are you hearing me? Now, I want you to pray. Look for somebody that you don't like too much. That brother, when you say, he always beat you to that sister. Look for that brother. So you like everybody? Eh? Okay, look for somebody you like. Look for one person. Look for somebody you like. Hold the hand of that person. Look for somebody you want to succeed. Not just like you. You want that person to do what? How can somebody who has not seen 10,000 naira insure 6 million and 6 million finish in less than 6 months? What is you? What is it called? Some of you think your problem is money. It's not money. That man said it. He thought his problem was money. If you don't deal with the yoke, when the wet will come, you will be regretting the way that man is regretting now. One prayer for the person you're holding. Lord, help my brother to pray tonight. Help my sister to pray tonight. Help my brother to do what? Pray. Now pray for that person. Now pray for that person.
It was a meeting like this.
in Benin.
When I
saw what poverty can do. Poverty can make your own mother to reject you. Forget this one, they say blood is thicker than water. Poverty will make water to be thicker than blood. I knew the only way out is only Jesus helping. A meeting like this. 4 days. Non-stop. I cried to God. 4 days. Non-stop. Nobody was leading prayer. This was some of you. We pray for 5 minutes and you're waiting for the next prayer point. I knew what the pain, the suffering I have seen. Me to pray. I prayed to an extent. Some pastors came, they bundled some of us and threw us out. I said, is this not prayer meeting? They said, they pray too much. You don't see poverty. Poverty will give you by God's prayer life. Except you know what serve Jesus. Have you seen where pastors are saying you pray too much? They say everything is not prayer. They can tell me today. I have proof that everything is prayer. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
You are good to pray. And this time around, make sure you are not too close to somebody. Because I want you to be free to pray as you want. So that in case that person is not serious, to leave the person behind. Every yoke on the neck of my destiny that is limiting me from going forward. Destroy it. Are you ready? Any demonic yoke at the end of my destiny that is limiting me from going further in life. Oh God of my father, destroy it.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
Nigeria, according to Femaso, he said, nobody travel in Nigeria any longer. He said, people are escaping. He escaped Nigeria to the United Kingdom. But he did not deal with the yoke. He started working in healthcare, looking after mental health patients. The yoke. You must deal with your yoke. Are you hearing me? God will bless you, but that blessing must not come when you have not dealt with your yoke. After the man escaped this hardship, wanting to get to his destiny, he started sleeping with patients who are colo. Mad women, for you to know that it's a yoke under camera the worship in a mad woman. Not nothing.
Oh.
If the youngest, okay, the youngest, fine. Mad woman. When the yoke is at work, it may allow you to get to the Jerusalem. It may allow you to get to Judea. It may allow you to get to Samaria. Drag you back. Oh, say to some of you, you are not praying aggressively. She went for checkup. They did full body scan. They said nothing is wrong with you. Just be going for sheep. They gave her a clean bill of health. 4 months later, the very month she passed a medical exam that qualifies her to practice abroad, the enemy gave her instant a straight form of cancer. When we say when you pray, you are doing a quiz prayer. There is bad boy in this life. Oh.
Yes, sir.
This life is worse. You play with your prayer life, you go see any other. This lady died the very month she passed her medical exam. What is that? No. They allowed her to get to where she wants to go. The truth in the look. Are you hearing me? You fight though, but not let fight make you not pray. You don't hear me? Every yoke. Let me share this with you. Let's say, every yoke that the enemy has planted in my life, in my destiny, waiting for when I will get to where God is taking me to before they draw it. Oh God, disappointed. Break the yoke tonight. Over my destiny. Are you ready to pray?
Yeah.
Yeah.
can you go go? They know that they are limited. Are you hearing me? Limit me. Let it end with me.
Yes.
Let my children not inherit it. You are a young man, a young woman. The yoke that limits my father and my mother, I destroy it from my life. Now, listen. God has started moving you. For those of you who are looking, they now pray to your shower. At work. Manifestation of the power of God. Destinies will be set free. This is the prayer point. Any yoke that limits my parents is destroyed from my life. Now, when you pray this prayer, close your eyes. Pray with all your mind. Are you ready to pray? Now, in the name of Jesus, every yoke that limits my father, every yoke that limits my mother, every yoke that limits my children,
let me go, let me make my mother. Yes, sir.
So that by tomorrow morning and evening session, what will hit you? Last prayer point. Every yoke limiting my progress. Your hand has seen progress. Before you know, it's as if something just stopped. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
You've seen promises before you know. Hallelujah.